You could say us Amish are strange and old-fashioned folk. What with our buggies, beards, and barn raisings. But to tell you the truth, we feel pretty blessed with the richness of our lives.
Wow.
Last year, 5 of our Amish teenagers were invited to experience life in Great Britain. Now we'd like to show some hospitality back and welcome some young English folk to come share in the pleasures of our Amish life.
Good morning, guys.
My name's Jonathan, and my wife Marietta and I were most privileged to be the first to host our British friends. Over the next few weeks, they'll stay with several different brethren from Pennsylvania to Ohio to get a true taste of just how us plain folk live. I just know we're all in for a treat. So far, our intrepid teenagers have learned to live the simple life.
It really was like going back in time.
And helped raise a barn. This week, they're on their way to Berlin, Ohio, to go farming with some of the hardest working Amish people around. The boys will be staying with Lloyd Miller and his family.
Hi. James. Lloyd.
They run a dairy farm with 100 cows and work 15 hours a day, 6 days a week.
You guys are loaded to stay here for a month instead of a week. Okay, well, listen, it is a little rain. Let's go inside. We'll just have a sit down and we'll get to know each other, okay?
The Millers are what we call New Order Amish. Don't be tricked into thinking they're modern folk, though, as they're much like the rest of us. They love God, live plain, and dress plain. Although you'll find a little less facial hair around here.
Just don't be, just relax, okay? We don't bite, we don't bark, and we are a dairy farm. We milk cows for a living. We run it as a family operation. We don't have any hired help, and we always get up on time, okay? You didn't get enough sleep last night, I can see that. We do get to bed real early. We never sleep late. Milking happens twice a day. Everybody pitches in and helps.
So, James, what are those?
Headphones. No, they're from my iPod. iPod, like.
iPod?
Yeah.
You carry it with you all the time in London?
Yeah. So, we play music on.
So, we just leave that in the room then?
It's going to be quite unusual for me to have it away from me.
Oh, yeah? So, I'm not trying to intimidate you. I want to be your friend, okay? Yeah. We just, you know. We don't want any of that.
Living under Lloyd's roof this week means living by his rules. Don't think our English girls will have it easy this week. They'll be working hard on a farm with slightly different animals.
I think this one is a poultry farm, so I just saw a little sign.
They're
going to make us kill chickens, aren't they?
Oh.
They'll be the guests of Nathan Mast and his soon-to-be extended family.
Hi. This is my wife, Anna, and this is Rhoda, my only daughter. And I have 5 sons, and Rachel here, which is my oldest son, Josiah's girlfriend, and they're planning on getting married.
So soon we'll have 2 daughters.
It's a lovely farm.
We enjoy it. It's back in. It's a lot of privacy. As far as behavior, I would just say, we just ask that you dress modestly, and we'd much rather hear you sing or whistle than cuss. So we hope you enjoy your stay here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
So you guys familiar with milking cows?
I've never done it.
Never done it.
Milking cows and mucking out barns takes up most of the day. So 3 fresh-faced, hard-working Englishmen are like manna from heaven for Lloyd.
This is a milking unit, and you just put it on right between their hind legs. And right now we're doing 70 cows, and time is important to me. We need to get the job done, so we'll get you to sweat a little bit. The Bible says the sweat of your brow, you're going to feed your family. I believe that. I think that's good for everybody, and I think we should sweat and know what it is to sleep good at night because you've worked hard, and that's a good feeling.
So you guys didn't necessarily grow up with any livestock?
I sort of mainly grew up in the countryside, so I was near sort of cows and stuff, but not to such an intimate level like this.
So is this something you look forward to, or is it like, oh, I don't even want to go there?
Still trying to adapt to it, really.
Okay.
It's just still quite a shock to me, sort of being out here, sort of doing stuff like this. My religion is to do whatever I want. I've never worked in my life. Because I don't particularly enjoy it. But I live on my own. My dad's in the army, so from like 6 to I was about 15, I hadn't really spoke to him. My mum's more sort of, I don't know, like, so we only really speak if we need to speak. I quite like it because it gives me a lot of freedom.
Do you live with your parents, or where do you guys live?
I live on my own. I've been living on my own since 16.
You lived on your own since you were 16?
Yeah. But it's we have these things called hostels. That is more because I was in care up until 16. So from 16, you get moved on.
Okay.
I didn't actually want to go into one, but the social services decided it was best. So I have to sort of follow.
Okay. Well,
I don't know of any single case of that type of scenario among the Amish culture. I don't mean that to sound, we've got this thing together, because there's other issues that crop up. You know, I have a heart for James to the point that, you know, I would like to sit down with him and just try to be there, because I think he needs somebody.
Check out the number, Gerald.
Farming provides not just food, but work for our families, too. Lloyd's eldest son, Jamin, works away from the dairy farm, leaving 14-year-old Gerald and his younger brother and sisters to help out.
So he grabs an iron, and she records it. This is my secretary. It's a pretty important job. If she messes up, the whole thing is junk. We need to start over.
Push it down and scoop some up, and then just like George is doing, you can just kind of spread it out. So you guys, do you have any chores or any responsibilities like this?
We've got a dog. I try and take him on walks and if needed. Mm-hmm. But I guess that's quite small in comparison to sort of 19 cows.
What about you, James?
No, I don't really have many chores. Mm-hmm. I have no set chores of my parents or anything like that.
I can imagine.
Being an outsider and sort of never having to do any of this, I'd sort of judge it as quite bad. But obviously, their dad, Lloyd, seems to think it's a good idea.
We'll get up early, we'll do the chores and spend some time together. I hope they can benefit. That's the main thing. I don't want this experience to be empty. I want it to really carry some weight and makes an impact.
Like most Amish farmers, the Mass family grow crops and rear chickens to help feed themselves and their community. But there's one big difference in the way things are run around here. The ladies work on the farms too.
I do laundry and breakfast, and then I come out to the chicken house.
So you're in charge of the chickens then?
Yeah, that's what I like to do.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know why, but I do.
A righteous person cares for the needs of their animals. So even the chickens get homes around here. And this is where the girls will be working.
It's going to smell a little bit and it's a little noisy, but they will absolutely not hurt you.
And then go ahead.
Oh, that really does smell, doesn't it?
Is it too strong for you?
A bit strong. Wow.
How many is there again?
There's 12,500 in each house.
Ooh, and how many houses do you have?
Two.
Why can't you keep them outside in a field or something? Is it just because you can't, you know, feed them?
Yeah, and you know, somehow I'd have to get them in during the night because of the rodents and things that would get after them,
foxes,
kill them.
Yeah.
Excuse me, sorry, can I get some air, please?
Yeah, you
Thanks.
Can go.
it's everything I knew it would be. It's disgusting, it's horrible, pretty inhumane, really.
It was overwhelming for him. But I don't really know why. I think that the birds, you know, they're comfortable out there.
This one vegetarian. I am bold, loud. We say bye bye. And I sort of, whenever and wherever possible, follow my own path. I originate from Sierra Leone. I'm from a humble background. I'm a student at Cambridge. And I've got a lot of opinions, and I think it's really important, especially for like young people like me, to do something that will make a change for somebody.
Students and workers, unite and fight!
I've always had a revolutionary spirit. I think it is really important for people to believe in something, enough to fight for it.
Unfortunately, that's what how we get chickens. It's a bit weird, isn't it, seeing it for real? Like, you wouldn't imagine. You don't think about it.
I have to dig deep into my soul.
Do you think they're planning to escape?
No, I'm being serious. I can see this is going to probably traumatise me.
Okay. Your top and bottom is the same, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
When they're not working, Amish ladies love nothing more than to weave a quilt. It's a chance for them to be together and share in the word of the Lord. This morning, Lloyd's wife Edna has invited Hannah, Charlotte, and Sienna to join them.
Hello!
Wow.
This is called a comforter, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the comfort goes for a charity purpose, like send it overseas to a poor country, like Haiti or Romania, people that can't afford to buy their own. Would you do something like this for charity at home in your country?
The only charity stuff I do is if I'm sorting my clothes out, you know, I'll bung my clothes in a charity bag and take it to the charity shop.
Yeah.
Without holy deeds to help us focus on a godly life, anyone can stray from God's path.
I'm kind of bored of the way I live at the moment. It's kind of very samey and repetitive.
You're like the fire.
Maybe there is something missing, you know, going out all the time and partying and being out with friends. You know, it takes up my time, and I want time to spend on something that I can really hold on to. I have a sort of emptiness inside me, which I can't describe. I don't know what I believe in and what I don't with religion, really. I don't have any strong connections with it. I don't go to church or anything. I feel like something's nagging inside me that I need to find out, but I'm not sure quite what it is. I've kind of made a little decision that perhaps I would like to believe in, you know, Christianity, believe in God, because obviously it's a very strong foundation for you and you're very passionate about it, and it's that's really interesting.
That makes my hair stand on end when you say that.
Makes you excited.
Yeah, I just love to hear that.
To us, that makes it worthwhile having you come here.
That's our ultimate goal.
Oh, that's lovely. I don't really know how to start believing.
I think it starts with, like, an interest. It takes time to make a relationship. Personally, like, I will talk to God like I'm talking to my friend. You know, I don't pray. I say, you know, hello, God. you know, today's been awful, you know, and... And I say, you know, I just talk to him.
You can feel it in here.
Well, I mean, I agree with what you said about if you believe, then you'll feel something, right? And I don't feel anything.
So what do you think will happen when you die?
I'll go back to the earth like I started.
So you think you're gonna...
I just know that my body will decompose.
Like you said, the body goes back to earth, from what it was created.
Yeah.
Your soul goes to wherever you chose. You can send it to heaven, you can send it to hell. According to the Bible, I mean, there's just no hope for the lost. Mm-hmm. I mean, I hate to say it. According to my Bible, it's eternal damnation. I still want to be your friend. I mean, I still love you. Yeah. I still like you. But it's been good discussing this.
Yeah.
I'm surprised people don't believe.
Especially
growing up the way we did. With nature out in the country, I mean, for us to say there's no God, we might as well say there's no gravity. I mean,
Charlotte's searching, and she's so hungry for this, and Sienna's trying to push it off. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a mystery to me.
I liked how much passion they have for their religion and God and Christianity.
I want to know sort of where this longing for faith kind of came from, really, because it's all just come from almost out of nowhere along the way in this trip. So I just wonder where it came from, really.
Yeah. I think it's kind of started with the whole belief thing, not believing myself. It's an empty feeling, you know, I don't have any belief, so perhaps that would fill my emptiness and my doubt. Well, I'm willing. If they are that passionate about it, you know, I'd like to be that passionate about it and go on a journey.
It would be incredible if you were to become a Christian, for me. I think that you need to really look within yourself and see, well, do I want to believe in a God that, you know, that died for me? Do you think that is, you know, I mean, that's an incredible thing to do, but do you think that that's even possible, you know? The fact that Charlotte wants to believe in Christianity is really wonderful, but I also think that perhaps she doesn't know enough about, you know, why she wants to believe Christianity. I think she needs to be in it for more than just the fact that she wants to feel a bit more confident in herself.
Okay. So today was a very, very deep day. I think the key word was challenge. I was challenged quite a lot today, and I challenged people quite a lot today.
Days start early for us Amish, but days for the Amish dairy farmer, well, they start even earlier.
Boys?
Hello.
Hey. Let's go milk.
Okay?
Okay. When I wake my family up, they hit the ground running. We'll be out in the barn, you know, in 5 minutes.
Hey, Jordan.
Hi.
Are you guys coming?
Yeah.
George, are you coming?
Hey, morning.
Morning.
Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed.
Dairy farming is exhausting, even if being part of the new order means you get to use electricity.
You know, when we milk together, we have a chance to communicate. It's a good time to kind of reflect, and it's a very comfortable place to be.
Have you seen the size of these udders?
I think it's going well. How are you doing, James?
I'm doing all right, actually. I ain't started yet, so...
Oh, yeah.
A cow just sort of pooed on me and Jordan, really, so... But not too happy about it.
I think the whole kind of process is a bit foreign to me, so... Finding it a little bit strange at the moment.
Bring it over, put it on this one, push the button in. There you go. Look at that. Squeeze it a little bit, it puts out more of the stuff. You might end up getting a little dirty hands, that's all right.
Dirty jobs are the fun jobs, mate. Remember that?
Yep.
It's good for your skin.
Yeah. It's good for your skin, yep.
Another about two milkings, we're going to take a vacation, and you guys are going to take care of it, okay?
We're going to get paid.
Paid?
Yeah.
Who's going to feed you?
I don't know.
Yeah, of course. Everybody wants to be paid. How do you know?
Got to get paid.
We Amish believe that we hold dominion over all God's creatures.
Increasing the water supply. I hope I'm doing it right, though.
It seems that Charlotte's the only English girl who agrees.
She's doing wonderful. She would make a good farm girl.
I think they enjoy their life as well as they can, because a chicken does not have the mentality to enjoy life like we do, you know. All they know is eat and drink, even if they would be on the outside, that's all they would do.
Mm-hmm, definitely. Anna explained really well how they're brought up and how well they're looked after. They do have a very good life, and you can see that. They have loads of space,
loads of food and fresh water. So all in all, it's been a really good morning.
It's not just animals that we Amish care for. We like to keep our guests happy, too. And there are few things worse than an upset visitor.
So what did you think about the chicken operation?
It's massively uncomfortable, to be honest.
We try to be very careful that they always have water and food, so they're comfortable, yeah, but they do have a short life.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It raised a lot of questions for me, really, to be honest, and kind of confirmed a few of my beliefs. To me, they seem like a commodity. So I was just wondering sort of how you look at them.
I don't know if anybody has a chicken for a pet. Yeah. You just, like a cat, will come up to you. Put a chicken arms away from you. They won't be your friend.
I know, I just don't feel like they should be commodities, quite frankly.
We will probably not agree on the chickens, but we don't have to be disagreeable about it, you know. I decided that I would try to be extra kind to her and, you know, to not let it bother me because she is my guest.
Respect and togetherness come high up on our list of Amish priorities. It's the same when it comes to dating.
Why don't you grab a seat somewhere and make yourself at home?
Oh, make myself at home.
Once two people start going out, they're expected.
How come you were so keen to make sure that that was your thing and you wanted to do everything yourself?
I have always enjoyed a challenge. Mm. Now, when I go to the chicken house, I make my own decision as what I want to do.
Some points in this journey, I found that some Amish women seem to almost depend solely on their husbands. Through your business, you show that you're just as capable as your husband. I think it's quite easy to be on the moral high ground, isn't it, until you try and see it from someone else's perspective. So I think that's one thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes you can be just so full of your own views that it's really hard to see it from someone else's side, especially when it's so radically different from anything you would have ever thought of.
You may have noticed that we quite like the Bible. Its teachings keep us on God's path. Sharing in those teachings is a privilege that we seldom offer to an outsider.
I brought you all a Bible, and it says GPS. Now, we all use a GPS to find what?
Your way around.
Your way around. So this is the GPS.
Thank you.
Shows you the way to get to heaven. And hope you enjoy Bible study. This is something that happens in our community for the young folks.
These Bible study evenings allow young Amish men and women to get closer to each other and to God.
Welcome to our Bible study tonight.
All our giants of fear and unbelief, God is bigger than any mountain that I can or cannot see.
And we hear the term world peace all the time. You know, what would it take? I think the answer is right here, where it says we are to live humbly and not to think that, hey, I'm better than you, but realize that we are all human beings, we're all on the same level. That reminded me of a former president, John Kennedy, who once made this famous remark, ask not what the country can do for you, but what you can do for the country. And this evening, I'd just like to take one step further. Ask not what others can do for you, but look what you can do for others.
It's quite interesting to see that their idea of a fun night out is to sort of sit on a porch and read the Bible and sing together. I think it was nice, though. I think it's nice that they can sort of all come together. I guess it's a lot cheaper than sort of a night out in London.
I just want to appreciate our thanks for being part of this evening. I think it's been tremendous. So wishing every one of you God's blessing.
Okay, thank you for coming, everyone.
Help me, Lord, when trouble and trouble meet me.
How did you like the Bible study tonight?
Oh, I loved it. I loved, you know, everyone getting together. And I kind of just sat back and listened, and what was said was really interesting and really inspiring as well. Really nice to see you guys get together, and just the Amish way of life, really. It was lovely. Thank you very much.
Most days in our Amish communities are taken up by hard work. But every now and again, we, like Josiah and his brother James, take the chance to relax and unwind by enjoying nature.
What's a nice day?
Good day for swimming.
Looks like it.
You got frogs in here, tadpoles, you got wildlife in here. So why don't we change and go swim?
Yep.
The water's all right, it's a bit chilly, but it's warmer than it would be if you were jumping into a pond at home. I also don't know of any ponds at home I'd actually jump into, unless I wanted sort of rabies or feces in my eyes.
It's a bit like the Lilo in Hampton Deep, just a lot colder.
The Lilo is still quite, it's still a swimming pool. This is really sort of at one with nature.
There's more girls at Lilo. Lovely girls at Lilo.
Do you think this would be better if this had more girls?
Definitely.
It's pretty obvious, I guess, that girls and boys don't mix too much around here. We try to keep ourselves as far from temptation as we can.
I've heard you're getting married.
Yes, you heard right.
How long have you been together?
About 10 months.
10 months.
And I can honestly say I've never touched her on purpose.
Do you literally mean actually physically touch, as in...
Physically touch.
As in almost sort of fingertips touching?
I've never intentionally touched her. I can honestly say I can see my girlfriend more clearly in a hands-off relationship than if you would not have a hands-off relationship. Rather strange, different.
Yeah, that was, I had an idea that you had a no hands-on relationship in my mind. I assumed you meant sort of sexually. So I mean, like, a hug, even a handshake is too far.
Yeah, a handshake is too far. Any touch will arouse a guy. It will lead you to somewhere you don't want to be. And yes, it's hard, but on the other hand, I can see the benefits. If you can love a girl without touching her, without having a sexual relationship with her before you get married, why couldn't you have an even better relationship with her after you're married?
I understand that from Joe's point of view, even the smallest of touch creates temptation, and temptation leads to sin. For me, I don't get aroused from shaking a girl's hand. But I can understand the logic behind it. He seems quite happy with it, and he, I guess, is looking forward to sort of his wedding day, where he gets to shake hands with her for the first time.
James and Lloyd haven't yet settled their disagreement, so they've decided to meet up, away from the rest of the family.
I was quite annoyed and very frustrated in the way that you felt that my family was broken, because my family isn't broken.
Okay.
Yeah, we're just independent from each other.
In the Amish society, we would promote that the children live with their parents and have a union and work with them.
It was just quite annoying that you sort of assumed stuff, really. But it's just quite commonplace in England and everywhere else that these things will happen.
You know, our home here has not been the perfect home either. My oldest son. But there was a time when I could not connect with him. I could not relate with him. I could not even talk with him. He spent a lot of time partying and doing drugs. He came in the wrong crowd, and they went a little too far, and they broke into a couple local businesses, and he was involved, and the law got behind him, and his jail sentence was for 180 days. I made lots of mistakes.
I was definitely shocked to find out that his son had been to prison. In the Amish world, that is unheard of. It was nice to be able to have that sort of bond with him, especially after he'd made all these assumptions that, you know, after my mum had been into prison, we were more or less in the same boat.
I mean, I didn't want to hurt you. I want to be a friend.
I think we may have got off on the wrong foot, I guess, sort of when I jumped out of the van in a bright pink hoodie and these loud headphones on.
Maybe we are certainly too quick to jump to conclusions, and I can see that's what happened, so I apologize for that. That's what it took to connect us, was that mutual family, and I think that's really neat.
There are few greater signs of friendship than for one person to break bread with another and have a little hymn singing too, of course.
A good evening is good food, but that's only the minor part, and then there's always good fellowship. If you don't know the song, just let the words sink in.
Oh, Lord my God, when I am awesome wonder,
fellowship between Amish boys and girls hits a high point at weekly youth groups. This is where most loving relationships blossom. In fact, it's where Josiah and Rachel got together.
How did you get together with your boyfriend? So we asked for my friendship.
Yeah.
Then we had a date a lot, about a month later.
My parents often tell me I'm going too fast with my boyfriend.
How long were you dating already?
We've been dating now for about 4 months. I mean, I know I've talked to a few of the old order, and like some of them do kiss on dates, and
I know.
You don't kiss on dates.
We have a hands-off courtship.
Completely?
Completely hands-off.
Why do you do that? Like,
if we ever marry or anything like that, it would be more special.
Mm-hmm. No regrets.
Yeah.
Yeah. No regrets
with you. For me, like, personally, I have had sex with my boyfriend. But I can see exactly where you're coming from. Like, you know, I mean, there was a time where I wanted to save myself.
And, right, right. Yeah. If we would do it, and the relationship wouldn't work out, we have no regrets.
If you would start it, and then we'd just go further and further.
Yeah,
and I've then once you get that. Married, it wouldn't be special anymore.
Yeah.
I think it'll take a little bit to fully grasp it, what we were kind of saying and trying to teach her. Whatever.
Because we don't want to make her feel guilty or something like that. It's just what we believe.
Mm-hmm.
And we just...
And we have different convictions.
Right. Or we might just be a little bit more radical than she is.
Because, you know, there was a point in my life where I thought, oh, yeah, I'd like to save my virginity for marriage. But, you know, obviously it didn't happen. You know, and they want it to be special, and they want it to be something that... You know, they will treasure forever because, you know, no one else has been able to kiss them, no one else has, you know, been able to touch them in that way or whatever. So for them, that's going to be something quite beautiful and something that means a whole world to them.
An Amish person without a Bible is like a buggy without a horse, clueless where to go or how to get there. Luckily for Charlotte, Anna and Rachel have a book that might help her on her Christian journey.
So how often do you study the Bible?
Every morning and every night.
Wow, dedication.
And I like to, it does take dedication.
If God wasn't there to talk to you and let your worries and doubts, would you have less confidence in yourself, what do you think?
Oh, yes. When you reach a decision and it's God's will, he gives you a kind of peace.
Yeah, that's what I'd really like.
perhaps turning into a Christian, it would give me more belief in myself. Mm-hmm. Do you think it would?
I think it would, yes.
Yes, I think so.
I'd really like to see if there is, you know, if there is a God. And I believe there is, because obviously you believe so strongly in it, so why wouldn't there be?
Yeah, there is a God.
I will start my journey and see where it takes me.
That's wonderful. And we will pray for you.
Yes, we will, definitely. It's an exciting journey. You can have this Bible.
Really?
Yes, you can.
Are you sure?
Would you like it?
Yeah, I'd love it.
Okay.
Oh, I'm excited now.
Read it every day. Read it every day. Yeah, okay. I'm very excited for you. Very excited for you.
Thank you.
I think Charlotte is a brilliant person. At the moment, she said she has no direction and she feels that her life is very much about herself. She seems to be very set on the idea that she wants to find faith. And I think if it's something that's going to make her happy and make her feel fulfilled, then it's a good thing. So I'm not concerned about her turning into a crazy fundamental person. I hope that her journey is a good one, and I hope that she finds whatever she's looking for, really.
I'm really excited, actually, to, you know, to start reading it. Just the fact that, you know, someone's going to be there that I can talk to and let my worries and doubts out instead of, you know, tiring me out. I'm going to be able to let it out and be kind of free, because I don't feel like I follow through with much. So following through with this, you know, it's a big thing. It's a total change, but I'm ready for it.
Bible and working hard keeps us plenty busy, but every now and again, New Order types like to come together to sing Christian songs and let off a little steam.
Playing music to our family is a relaxing time. It's a time of unwinding. We let the children express themselves. Well, we wouldn't accept anything with a punky, where you would actually, you know, everybody's swaying, and we want it to be a real old-fashioned more type. I know it's way out of style, but it's definitely what we enjoy. Just characters get revealed when we're playing music.
If you didn't think I was crazy when I got here, you're gonna think that when I leave.
We could probably make up a song and we'll put some lyrics to it. I've done this before, have you?
No. I'll play over it.
Okay. Let's make up a song about someone. How old are you?
14.
What's that? Gerald. He's only 14, but Gerald has more responsibility than me, and I am 18 years old. Wakes up in the morning at 5:30. Doesn't even bother drinking a cup of tea. Doesn't need it, unlike me. All of us from England would like to say thanks. You have welcomed us into your home, and it's been great. I'm just mumbling, there's nothing to say, but thank you very much, I'm gonna leave today. Thank you. The end.
The children haven't heard anything like that before.
Oh, we'll talk about it, I'm sure.
Yes.
This is going to be a conversation piece.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I don't think it was Jesus, but someone clever once said that the journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step.
Santa is back. Yeah!
The road might be long, and we may get lost from time to time, but with a little help from God and each other, we'll all get to the promised land.
This week I've surprised myself. I successfully managed to really see things from someone else who has a very, very different opinion to mine. I managed to see where they were coming from, that more than one person can be right. So I definitely take back. I'll take that back with me. Very, very much for everything.
Lloyd, thank you for a very interesting experience, I think.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I personally wasn't expecting to make, like, a connection with Lloyd. Our religious views and our lifestyles are miles apart. In a weird way, it was nice to be able to make sort of a communication like that.
We shall never forget you boys.
All right.
Yep.
See you again.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
There's a limit to colour. I feel a little explosive.
George is the one, just by looking at him, I'd say he's good at sound. The other one is kind of iffy.
I honestly think this is awesome. Mennonites and pimping out their cluggy. It's getting more and more modern, but you're keeping the core value.
You're still sitting behind that horse and still driving at 10 miles an hour.
You can take part in a live Q&A with Charlotte, Hannah and Sienna right now. Head to channel4.com/Amish. 2 years on from when we last saw them and much has changed. A brand new three-parter starts next Tuesday at 10. Prepare to be kicked from the saloon to the lounge bar in This Is England 88. Next tonight on 4, everything's crossed. £1 million drop, live.